switched my devices, and today I'm recording on my iPad, which I've never done that before on this channel. And the reason why is when I first got my microphone, I tried using it both on my phone and on my iPad. And the thing was that when I tried it on my iPad and I watched the video recorded later, there was no sound on the video. And I thought, like, well, maybe this microphone just doesn't connect to the Apple devices. But today, I gave it another go. Change the light a bit. It's weird because of the microphone, which is here. Today, I gave it another go. And it worked. Like, I retried it and it still works, like, actually works. And, well, I thought, maybe this is saying something. I should record on my iPad. Anyway, so a little bit different setup, and you can't really see me, just my face, which is, well, maybe a little bit uncomfortable, but maybe this is gonna be just one this time. I'm just gonna check the sound, and I've got a slight feeling that iPad may record the sound better than my phone. But there's one really big advantage of such a setup, of recording on the tablet, and my phone, is that I can actually do a phone sounds video. So this is my phone, it's Huawei, and I usually record on it, but it makes really nice tapping sounds, you know, nail tapping and whatnot, and I really wanted to try it, but I had no way of recording the phone sounds, because well, none of my other devices can connect to the microphone, but now it turns out they can. So let's try it out. That's it. Oops. I'm sorry, I'm having a real disaster with lighting this time. Usually it's better because usually I have three flashlights. Today it's only two flashlights because I need to move the chair closer to me. My back is really hurting now. has taken it back, and I couldn't find it again. So I'll just have to wait until he comes home and ask him to give it back to me. Please, Dad. Oh, I'm trying to turn the camera in a better angle. Yep. Sorry. I can figure something out, I think. I'm sorry I'm doing it this in process of the video. I thought it could be better, but you can see that I was a bit wrong at that.
Like, just my
practicing all the necessary stages of the exercise. So I was trying to do that, but we never get to the end. And firstly, it's a bit pointless, like when you perform some manipulation, it would seem that the point of that exam would be to check whether you can actually perform that manipulation, not just the preparations for it. But the organizers seem to have thought otherwise. Fine. So part one, don't know how it went really, but emotionally it was a complete disaster. And in fact, I don't know, maybe okay. Today was part two, how it went. So emotionally it was better, because we were more familiar with the format, like even the rooms, they were designed a little differently because we had completely different exercises in the same rooms. But today, well, it was the second time I got there. It was the second time I knew how it all was run. And I was a little more calm. And I certainly was a lot more calm when I was performing the exercises. Yeah, I didn't get to the end of any of them, but when we came out of the rooms, my groupmates and me, we discussed, and the stages that we got through were completely the same, so in the given time, we all managed to perform the exact same volume, amount of operations. Okay. Well, I tried my best at completing each stage, and so I hope it will play a part in my result, and the result will be positive, because I don't know how else to prepare for the exam. Sorry. I never loved hearing tapping sounds. Like, it was never really a big trigger for me. But ever since I started making ASMR videos, I've been loving making tapping sounds. I don't know why, but really, they sound really nice to me most of the time. Like, not into the microphone, but most times I think that when you listen to them already recorded, they don't sound so great. So there's a bit, that's a real pity. But yeah, as they say, it is what it is. Love that stuff. And I've also got see it in my preview, a chewing gum. Today it's the all watermelon flavored gum. Fantasy. I like fantasy more than science fiction, but it it's still not really my thing. I prefer like more earthbound stuff, like just drama and comedy. But I was watching Star Wars. That was because I used to be friends with a guy who was really a lot into that stuff, like Star Wars and science fiction, all sorts. And he was very passionate about his hobbies and beliefs. So he really wanted to, I don't know, maybe like educate me on something or illuminate me. I'm not laughing at him. It's a really good thing to do, and I respect him. We don't really chat much. We used to be classmates at school, but it's been like more than 3 years now, and we chatted last year a lot. But now we don't really, because we're both back at universities and we're both deathly busy, and we've never been really close. Like, we chatted, but we weren't close. He was trying to educate me on something, and we were constantly having arguments back at school because of our completely different positions in life. But still, I was interested in his friendship with him, and so I followed his advice and watched Star Wars. At first, it was alright, although I don't really like battle scenes. It's not my stuff either. Well, it's not my thing. It was hellish to read The War and Peace by Tolstoy, because, well, there are 4 volumes, and a great part of it is dedicated to battle scenes and just war stuff, and I'm completely not interested in that. Not because I'm a girl. I know girls who are interested in that stuff, but I'm not. And I know boys who don't like that stuff. It's completely fine, it's just your taste. I'm a pacifist, I'm against war at all costs. So, I was talking about my guy. We didn't date, in case you're wondering. No, I'm gay, I don't like guys. But just friendship. You know, he is an Orthodox Christian. And I'm an atheist, and have always been an atheist, but he couldn't really understand my position, and I never agreed with his position because it was too passionate, and mine possibly was too dispassionate for him. But he was trying to get me into his church. Like, he invited me to a Sunday service once, and I went, and I just wanted to know more. Like, I cannot believe in something. Just like, simply believe. I can't. But I'm interested to know people's position and why they are, why they are into that religion, and how it is to be religious. Not just all this philosophical stuff. He was so much of a talker that even during the service he didn't stop talking. He was always trying to explain something to me. So even some grannies had to, like old ladies had to turn around and tell him to keep his mouth shut. He gave me a book. Not really religious, just some old priest. tastes, like memoirs. And I was reading it, and I liked it because there was no like propaganda, just life and his. It was good. Star Wars. Maybe it's nice if I watch it again sometimes. It's just too huge for me. That guy even gave me some electronic books about Star Wars and even some screenplays, I think. So he was really trying to get me into and get me to know that stuff. And I really respect him for that. Because when you try to give somebody all you know, like, give it away, I think that deserves respect. And, yeah. I've let you so far away from any topic. Well, I just hope you're not bored by my waffle. I should probably be wrapping up the video because it's nearly 29 minutes. So we're close to 30. Alright, let me say my goodbyes. So, firstly, thank you for watching. I really appreciate that a lot of people come to my channel and watch my videos lately. That really gives me a huge support and, well, thank you to everybody who has subscribed and just watched. I hope you like it. If you like the videos, please click the like button so that I know that you really like it. Leave some comments. And especially about today. Well, firstly, are you asleep or not? Secondly, are you bored or not? And thirdly, whether you liked my phone sounds or not. And fourthly, the fourth point, whether you like the recording on the iPad or from my phone, like I usually do. Maybe the sound quality is better on the iPad. Again, remind everybody that if you are subscribed to my channel, please turn the notifications on so that you always get a ring about my new videos, so that you can get them seen in your recommendations. Alright. And, well, come over here again. I'll be glad to see you back with another video, probably tomorrow. And that's where I'll see you. For now, have a nice time. Have a great Friday.